Well, what's going on, everybody? This is Will back once again for a little bit of a cooking vlog. It is Independence Day, so happy Independence Day to everybody. And I need to not look right there, I need to look at the camera. But what we got going on today is, I already have steaks marinating in Winchester sauce, or worst word in the world sauce. And soy sauce. Got my shrimps thawing out. Jet said that she might want some fried rice, so I'm gonna do fried rice and everything in just a little bit. Well, not a little bit, but you know, just getting prepared. Going to start making a little bit of a sauce for the shrimps and everything in just a moment. And that's the secret ingredient for the steaks, that little shake right there. And then we gotta get I gotta make another shake for the shrimp seasoning also. But I'm gonna go ahead and start getting my little marinade together for those. Onion, garlic, a whole lot of butter. Jet's gonna go get some other ingredients, so I'm gonna add also lemon, orange, and a little bit of MSG. I think I asked her to go get some chicken bouillon. So, but yeah. She'll be pretty good once she gets back and everything. Might do some sausage and all that type of stuff in it also. Got some baby potatoes and corn that's going in it also. And all that is going to be cooked on the grill. But we shall see whenever she gets back and everything. So y'all take it easy till then. Also, while the rice and everything is going and other stuff is going in, all that mess, whatever, trying not to get jumped, I got a whole lot of thoughts going on. I'm going to go ahead and start prepping just extra little ingredients for the fried rice. This is like some chopping and stuff like that right there. So you know, go ahead and get some of the stuff out the way. And hygienic thing, always clean your cutting board. It's overlooked, but yep, gonna keep on keeping on. I'll probably set a little tripod and everything. I know we all know how to just chop vegetables or whatever, but you know, b-roll, that type of stuff. But yep, a few other things I like to do whenever I'm marinating steaks or chicken or anything like that right there, after about say 15, 20 minutes or whatever, 30 minutes, just depending on how busy I am, I normally just flip them or whatever, that way you know, try and keep it evenly marinated. And also with the rice and everything, I should have did it yesterday, but I didn't know that Jet would want fried rice or whatever to take with her and stuff. Like 3/4 chicken broth and the other 1/4 water, whatever you know amount that you're doing. But yeah, there's a way that we can try to dry it out, because it's best to use more like day old rice, whatever, like dried rice or whatever. But you can put it on a cooking sheet. That's what I did last time. Just put it on a cooking sheet and just spread it out so it dry a little bit quicker. But yeah, a few little tips. Again, just like last time, spring onion, 1 chili pepper for a little bit of heat, fresh garlic clove, and fancy on is a shallot. I might put in some ginger, I don't know yet, but we shall see. Then it's just gonna be us, whatever, I'm gonna use a lot of garlic. Got 3 cups. 1 for the trash part, 1 for the good part, and then 1 for the other ingredients that don't really need to be mixed. I go in later at the end, like the sweet onion or spring onion and chili. I'm going to crush it, because if you don't, that thing will go everywhere. Okay. I probably like mine as fine as I can get it. Mouse, I ain't trying to cry today. Too much of this shallot again because it's just us and noise. Here we go. That's no better. No better. See if I can do the old sexy citrus slicing. Which I should have. Unless it is one piece. Yeah, I think I'm gonna do it too small. That's what she said. And again, just me personally. Fine as I can get. Again, need to invest in a slap chop. You might can hear my neighbors out there. But they, yeah. Older mall cars. Pretty nice cat. And again, I'll add this right here to our garlic. One chili pepper. You'd be surprised how much just one chili pepper. Which I wanted a thinner one, but it is what it is. How much flavor it adds. It's not a lot of heat, but I mean, it's just enough. And basically, all the heat is from those guys right there. And basically all it is right here is just, it also adds a little bit of color to the meal. That way you just don't have this brown rice just chilling there. So I'm just trying to do this right here and then touch my dang face and touch my eyes. And then plus I don't have like a towel, like a real chef and everything, but like throw it on my shoulder. Keep wiping my dang hands off. And again, also, you know, feel free to add as little or as much as you want. If you ever are making like a broth, these ends right here are real good for broth.
not too bad. And all of them right there bust open into a lot more from the smaller circle. Well, they would if I hadn't just chopped. Again, I'm the type of person that if I see certain things, I won't like it. I won't want to eat it. But if I don't see it, then it's not really there. You know how your parents used to say, well, just try it. Just try it. You won't even taste it. Yeah, well, if I see it, I'll taste it. Color at the very end of it. Now that my sous chef has arrived, he's gonna help me fix some of this stuff. I might use one in the back. Or you want the cleaver. Yeah. Picky. Basically, that right there is going to be going in the shrimp and all that whatnot. Like this, you got one from the store or went to the store, got the sausage, got the chicken bouillon, some extra worst word in the world sauce because I ran out. Some more all purpose seasoning, and some corn again, got baby potatoes and whatnot in there. Lemon and orange to kind of cut down on a few of the acidics, even though lemon is acidic, but add a little bit more flavor. So I guess I'm about to start making a little marinating for the shrimps. I'm apparently gonna start with 2 sticks of butter because that's what everybody and their mama said that you gotta start with, is butter. They always say unsalted, but whatever. Butter's butter to me. And after this, I'm gonna chop up an onion, put the onion in it. And then start adding in a few more little sauces. Be aware what kind of pan that you're using. Apparently this saucepan has a dome in the middle of it. That's why you can see everything is running to the sides. Should have seen me when I first started cooking it. It was a little bit of a pain in the ass. Trying to get stuck.
Pain in the ass?
Yes, pain. That's a pain in the ass. So if you notice, added some more garlic right there. So now we're gonna get to have a little bit of fun and throw some spices in this thing. Like one recipe says like a teaspoon or whatever, but whatever, whatever. So just until you feel like it's right. Because apparently you see that we ain't got no shaker.
And then just till you feel like you need to stop. And then another easy thing to do, whatever, is just, you know, taste as you're going, obviously. Because sometimes somebody else's recipe might not be the best of your recipe. And bring it back down to a simmer and let that reduce some. It does. Yeah, it's probably it is. Because it smells like straight shrimp over there. Oh, yeah. Yeah, it just hit me too. Sous chef putting in work over there, deveining fresh shrimps. Well, being that neither one of us can find the other cutting board, this is how you innovate. Can't tell, it's just a lid to a big ass bowl turned upside down. We're gonna take the lemon and the orange. And squeeze both of these right here. How about that transition? Seamless. I know people might think, well, you just use orange juice to extract. It ain't the same. But, because I'm lazy, if I had thought about it, yes, I would probably just got the little plastic cartons of orange juice and lemon extract. That's that good shit.
No,
that's later. I just about forgot. Gonna add a little bit of chicken stock to this right here. And then reduce it down some more. Send some more sausages, and then I will put the steak over there in the pan, put my shake on it, both sides or whatever, and then chill it in the fridge till later. Basically just put a cup or half a cup, whatever you like, again, whatever you feel like putting in there. And another secret little ingredient. And let everybody know where I get certain things from. But basically it's lemon pepper infused. Whoever always said that all you need is just salt and pepper on a steak must don't know how to cook. They have no idea about flavor. They must smoke their entire life. And I get it. You know, you want to taste the meat of the steak, full beans, but I also like flavor. Just me, personal preference. And whatever I said, well, just put it on the steak right before you put it on. Why? It's just gonna fall right off.
It ain't got no time to soak in. Putting this right here on it, covering up, refrigerator. It's gonna soak in. It's gonna caramelize. It's gonna look good. It's gonna taste good.
Luckily, she reminded us that needed to go ahead and start at least halfway cooking the potatoes before everything goes on the grill. So don't forget to do that.
And obviously, just because of what the day is, Independence Day, I wish I would have got a daiquiri, but it is what it is. Again, we're gonna rock with what we got. So we're gonna make a red, white, and blue frosty. Cause I just love a slushy. Well, being that the entire thing that I just recorded stopped recording, it is what it is. But I wanted it to be more layered, but it is what it is. So we're going to just keep rocking with it. But happy Independence Day. Got the grill going. And again, if you're like me and kind of half-assed poor, you ain't got to have no Traeger, no pellet grill, no what other fancy-ass grills that's out there. And that bitch came straight off of Amazon. Got one little wrap done. Gonna probably show you how to do this next one. Kinda, you know. But yeah, you get what it is. Damn! The hell you come from? Ninja? Jeez. Make some noise next time.
You butthole.
The knife?
The spoon.
Oh,
I know it was. Basically, whenever you're making these little pouches, I guess it's like whoever you like most get the most shrimp. Most meat. I got them all the same damn red bottoms. And bought them all the same damn fragrance. Up to my bitch drive Range Rovers. None of my bitches can stay over. Up to my bitches look good as fuck. Your bitch look like a booger wolf. I sent two of my bitches in the club. And I know they know about each other.
My bitch driver off.
Us?
Lush.
Yeah, man.
And this is where that marinade come in at.
It's on.
You know we had to do it again, right?
We had to do it again, boy. Uh-huh. Uh-huh. Go to the scene of these ladies, man.
Oh, oh, oh. So I'm up first.
Baby, how you doing? Hope that you're fine. Wanna know what you got in mind tonight.
Got me feeling like you're
a sea girl. I can't leave you alone. Take a shot of this here Patron. And it's gonna be done. VIP, then got way too crowded. I'm about to end up calling you tonight. Too soon, I look at your girl. Tell her you're shaking the scene. Pull up, peep, shotgun in the GT with you. She said, oh,
and that is why you let them bitches chill. She has done all soaked in and whatnot. It's gonna taste great. I appreciate it though. I was just gonna ask you if you could record it also, but it's all good. You got slow mo on that thing?
I do.
That bitch thick, boy. And while them is going or whatever, because they're more on direct heat or whatever, we're going to put all of our little batches and everything, in direct heat. So even though the steaks and everything grilling, these is gonna be cooking up top. It might have a little bit of a tight fit though. Oh, we might can squeeze her in. But you get what I'm saying. Besides it being hotter than a son of a gun out here. Oh yeah, boy. Might have to move thick and to the middle.
Yeah, I got some down bitches I can call. I don't know what I would do without y'all.
Man, it's time to do the fried rice. So basically, we're just gonna heat it all again and then pour it out. Get a good wake. This is like a smoking flavor or smoky flavor. Basically, just like a cast iron skillet seasoning. Now, I'm about to pour this out and start fresh. We're gonna put in the shallot and the garlic first. The old melee that we did earlier today. Bad at tossing, boy. Make sure you keep everything moving. Smash the rice down. Keep it moving so it don't clump up. Try and keep the heat in it. MSG in the old shaker. A little bit of white pepper. And now, about to add that little bit of heat in that fresh onion.
spread down.